Hey, what's up? Dorfira here from VidoRM. Today we can take a look of how we can create these nice looking lines of here. With how we can create these rounded, colorful lines of here using Photoshop. All right, let's get started by opening up Photoshop. And today we can take a look of how we can create these two different kind of these. There will be two kinds. There's the thin one and the flat one that is kind of close to each other. And there's this one that is kind of giving more space, and it's kind of thin. As you can see, the streak and the line of here is kind of thin of here. So that's why we're gonna take a look today. We can take a look of how we can create the differences, and yeah, that's how we're gonna do it today. Okay, now we're gonna go ahead and create a file. Click on file. Sorry. New 500 height and height, no, sorry, five width and height 500 pixels 72 pixels slash inch RGB color 8-bit white, and click OK. And you can receive a blank white page of here. So what we need to do is go ahead and click, double click on this and just click OK, and double click again and click on gradient overlay. Change the style to linear, the size scale it to 93, and click on the gradient, click on this color here and change it to red, kind of a light gray, red lightened one, and that's good. And change the white to darken red, like that, little darker. That's good, and that's the background. Alright, now let's go ahead and click on ellipse tool and change the color and create a new layer. And now go ahead and make a little circle over here, and that's a green one. You can change the color by clicking over here and changing the color. Alright, now let's go ahead and filter. Go ahead down here to destroy it, and then click on wave. Alright, click randomize until you see a straight line like this one, and just click OK, and this is good. Now we need to go ahead and filter same way, but you're gonna change it to down here, the one up top to wave, says twillers. Now as you can see, now we're going to the minus place. Now as we go this way, as you can see the numbers, there's nothing about it. But if you put a minus like this, it's gonna go all the way. See, as you can see, it takes itself all the way back here. So what we need to do today is first, what we need to do is go ahead and kind of make it take it all the way and just click OK, and that's what we get. It's kind of flat and it's not thin. And let's go ahead and duplicate this layer. Right click, duplicate a layer, or you can do this in the shortcut keys, Control J on a Mac, Command J. Now double click on it, go ahead and change the color, click on color overlay, change it to red, and same place, same thing. Now we're gonna kind of make it a little larger, so move it all the way to 99 minus. Now as you can see, that is too large and does not look good. So Control Z to undo and filter again, same thing. Now we can go forward to about 6. Now as you can see, it looks good and it's nice, it's better than before. Same thing, duplicate and double click, change the color to yellow, and okay. Now let's go ahead, do the same thing but move it forward to about 5 something, and just click OK. And that's how you create a nice looking image of there. I mean, how that's how you create this thing. But this one, we got it. It's kind of close to each other. It's kind of little flat. We just this one was a little small, and this one is a little bigger. So now let's go ahead and take a look of how we can create this nice thin rounded lines like this. So as you can see, would you see the difference then now between this one and this one over here? Cause I think you see it. All right, now I'm gonna turn these layers off, and I'm just gonna go ahead and just rectangle tool, and I'm just gonna copy this background, edit, copy. All right, and I'm just gonna click on this layer over here, and I'm just gonna go edit and paste. Alright, now we're gonna create a different one. We're gonna create a thin one. What we're gonna do is do the same thing. So I'm just gonna close these ones. Alright, and I'm just gonna shift. And alright, now we have a background. It's the same. We're gonna double click. No, we don't need to double click. Create a new layer. Just we can just do the same thing as we did. Once I get to the part that we need to look what the difference is, and I'm gonna just tell you. And now I'm gonna go a little faster. All right, I'm gonna create a new screen. All right, filter. All right, wave and straight. Filter again. Okay, now differently. Now we're gonna go. Now this is the different one. Now we're gonna go this way. So as you see, we're going this way. Before we're going this way, and there was a minus over here. Now there's no minus. Now we're going this way. That's a different. Click OK, and as you can see, it's starting to give us the thin looking. Let's go ahead and just do create, Control J, Command J on the Mac, and just do the same thing. I'm just gonna do it faster because I think I'm running out of time. And there's another thin one. Change the color, double click, color overlay, that's good. And duplicate a layer, Control J, Command J on the Mac, same thing. Alright, and now it's gonna look a little smaller. Alright, now I'm gonna just separate into pages, and so you can see the difference. Alright, this is that. Now I'm gonna turn on this one on. I'm gonna turn this on now. Alright. Alright. As you can see now, the difference is that this one is thin. The lines are very thin, as you can see. This one there's a thin part and there's a flat part, which means that this one is a little bigger and it's a little closer to each other, as you can see. Alright, I hope you can see the difference too. Then now, and I hope you learned something. Please subscribe, like, and comment. And this is Rashidi saying goodbye.